Why do you have such conviction that Pika is the best tool, generative AI, for video content creation?
Everyone on the internet wants to be able to create content. We've all been creating more and more content over the past couple of decades as creation has become democratized by technology and software. But video remains really, really hard. And that's why we're so excited by Pika, which is targeting all of us regular people, as opposed to other products that are targeting more professionals and enterprises. And that's why we think the opportunity for Pika is just so, so massive.
Okay, interesting. So, because you back a Lightspeed Stability AI, which is also doing similar things. We've got Meta and Google, I'm sure, are going to be interested in creating video. What is the moat here? Is it about a team? Is it about how they've just ultimately shown more deep tech expertise? What is it that stands them apart?
So if you look at the companies that have already generated massive amounts of value in AI so far, companies like OpenAI through ChatGPT or Midjourney and their imaging model, these companies all combine both their own foundational model combined with a consumer application. And that creates an incredible feedback loop of content being created and then delivered directly to the users. And that's exactly what Pika is doing. They have their own brand new video model and they have their own consumer application. And so we think there's an incredible moat to be built through that approach.
And I assume incredible amount of money to be built. And I'm interested as how are they thinking of charging? Where will they be able to? Because we all know how costly this is to build this sort of technology, but how are they actually getting Gen Z in particular to part with money for it?
Yeah, I don't want to spoil any of their surprises, but again, to go back to the two companies I just mentioned, OpenAI, they're rumored to be generating more than $1 billion in revenue annually already, and they've only been in market for about a year.
But the enterprise is some point for them.
It's actually in a big part due to their consumer application, ChatGPT. So many of us are using that application now, so many of us are paying for the premium features, and that's the same with Midjourney. So there is a model being built here that's a new type of business model that is unique to AI products.
We were just showing a video of Pika, and what's interesting to note about that video is that everything that we're currently showing on the screen is AI generated, right?
That's right.
How has this company scaled? If all of our audience on Bloomberg Technology is watching that and says, okay, I've got to be using Pika, will Pika be able to sustain and be able to handle this big jump in traffic or volume that our show might create for them?
Pika Labs has been founded by two incredible Chinese-American women, two of the most academically decorated people in all of AI, Demi Guo and Chenlin Meng. And I have full confidence in them and the team to build a product that is known not only amazing for creating video, but also absolutely stable and robust from an infrastructure standpoint. So tons of confidence in the team.
Mike, what can you tell us about the infrastructure? Are they training on NVIDIA and H100s? What other silicon are they using? Who is their cloud partner in this instance?
Again, not something I really want to reveal. That's more for the founders to reveal.
Oh, go on.
But I can assure you that Pika is developing with the latest and greatest, their own state-of-the-art model, and it's ready for prime time.
More broadly, therefore, is this the area that you're continuing to gravitate towards, the democratization of AI within the consumer base?
As I talked about last time when I was on, I really believe that the history of the internet has proven that massive amounts of value become unlocked when companies democratize creativity. These companies, they enable anyone and everyone to create things that were previously very, very hard to make. And simultaneously, they unlock new formats that create tremendous amounts of value. And so we've seen this before through platforms like Instagram and YouTube and TikTok. And I think AI will usher in a new era of companies and value like this through companies like Pika and the company that I was mentioning last time, Tome.